Who Forgive your neighbor the hurt he does you. And when you pray, your sins will be forgiven. If a man nurses anger against another, can he then demand compassion from the Lord? Showing no pity for a man like himself, can he then plead his own sins? Mere creature of flesh, he cherishes resentment. Who will forgive him his sins? Remember the last things and stop hating. Remember dissolution and debt and live by the commandments. Remember the commandments and do not bear your neighbor ill will. Remember the covenant of the Most High and overlook the offense. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Your brother does something wrong, don't have it out with him alone, between your two selves. If he listens to you, you have won back your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you. The evidence of two or three witnesses is required to sustain any charge. But if he refuses to listen to these, report it to the community. And if he refuses to listen to the community, treat him like a pagan or a tax collector. I tell you solemnly, whatever you bind on earth shall be considered bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be considered loosed in heaven. I tell you solemnly, once again, if two of you on earth agree to ask anything at all, it will be granted to you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three meet in my name, I shall be there with them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We stand and profess our faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten of faith, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was the count of the Virgin Mary, and he came down. For our sake, he was crucified with the conscious light, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, but I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Confident in God's love and care for us, we now bring our intentions before him.
blessed always with the courage to lead the church with wisdom, integrity, and compassion.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For all in positions of authority, that they will be aware of the influence of their words and actions have on others, and so seek always to speak and act in ways that respect the dignity of human life in all its stages.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For all who seek forgiveness, that they may find compassion, reconciliation, and peace in their lives.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For all who serve generously, yet quietly, in their communities, especially those who support others through words and acts of kindness and encouragement, may they receive the grace of God in their lives.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We bring before God those who have died, those whose anniversaries occur at this time, and those who mourn.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the parishes of Sacred Heart, Jew Magna, and St. Pius X, Wittywood, and our own parish, to our belief in Jesus, the Son of God, may manifest itself in our words and deeds with all we encounter in our parishes, our communities, and our world.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We ask Mary, Mother of Christ, to pray with us and for us, as we say, Hail
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In the silence of our hearts, we turn to our Father with our personal intentions.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear the prayers we make in faith and to always give us a living sense of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father. For God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. And by partaking of the sacred mysteries, we may be faithfully delighted in mind and heart. Through Christ, Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sin we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exultation we invoke. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Giving thanks that you have held us
worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have preached you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Grant that your faithful Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacraments, may some benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just to mention a few things coming up. In our parish, we have the ABC course beginning on the 10th of October about being Catholic, about becoming Catholic. For anyone who wishes to know more about the Catholic Church, thinking about being received into the Catholic Church, or those baptized that have not received the sacrament of Holy Communion, or confirmation, that's the course for you. So if you're interested or know anybody who is, that first meeting is on the 10th of October. We also have a meeting coming up to do with our 150th anniversary in 2026. That will be on Tuesday, the 26th of September, in the parish centre. If you want to be involved with that, please do come along to that meeting. Our diocesan day on the 7th of October, those of you who signed up, still places if you still wish to get. And forms are available for our first Holy Communion course, which will begin after Christmas. So if your child is in year 3 or above, and they'd like to make their first Holy Communion, then please ask for a form from me. We also have some vacancies on our governing body at St. John's Catholic Primary School down the road. And Mike Simmons is here, the Chair of Governors, and also our head teacher, Tracy Simmons. And if you wish to know more, Mike will be handing out leaflets for anyone who wants to know more about becoming a foundation governor. Very rewarding and challenging experience. So if any of you feel inspired to do that. For those of you who are rugby lovers, great weekend we've had already. France victorious in their opening game. We had an emphatic win by Ireland yesterday. And an unexpected win, I think, which many would say, from England against Argentina, but a fine performance by England. And today Wales and Scotland enter their campaign, so we wish them all the best. If you love rugby, it's a great feast of rugby. If you don't like rugby, hey-ho. Have a nice weekend. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is
ended. Thanks be to God.